The app is called WAD Notify, and it's actually only technically an app on Android devices where you can download it from the Play Store. For iPhones, it's more of a feature, one that you enable by going to your settings and looking for exposure notifications. Once activated, you don't need to open the app again, it works in the background. So, how exactly does it work? Basically, the app randomly generates a secret ID number for your phone. When your phone gets within Bluetooth range of another activated phone, the two share ID numbers with each other. Your phone will secretly log that number and hang on to it for 2 weeks. The only other data it records is how close your phone was to theirs and for how long. It doesn't know who they are or where the contact took place. Even that little bit of data it records isn't something anyone can actually look at, not the user, Apple, Google, or public health officials. Okay, so now let's say that someone you stood near at the grocery store comes down with symptoms later. They go and get tested and it comes back positive for COVID. The public health office can give them a special code, and the sick person enters that code into their phone. Now, their secret ID number basically becomes flagged. Your app will scan its log and realize it has that number on it, meaning you were recently within Bluetooth range of someone with COVID. Then it'll check to see if you were close enough to them for long enough that you should be concerned. If the answer is yes, you get an alert. All that says is that you might have been exposed, and it gives you advice on next steps. It does not tell you where, when, or by who you might have been exposed. It also does not alert anybody else. This information stays as private as you want it. And that's it. Now remember, even though for you iPhone users, this technology is probably already on your phone, you need to opt in order to activate it. Today, Governor Inslee said already more than 200,000 Washingtonians have done so. He also said studies show even if just a few people have the app, it can reduce the spread of the disease. Casey Decker, Crem 2 News.